It is one of our favorite times of the entire week when we can visit with our friends from the Blank Park Zoo, especially when we can visit with Jesse Lowry from the Blank Park Zoo to talk about one of her passions, because we are talking about plant grow fly here this morning, Michelle.
Yeah, very exciting. Mm-hmm. You brought us some things to take care of after you're gone too, which I love.
I did.
Okay, so a plant grow fly is something that we've talked about on this program for a while now, and this is one of your so-called pet projects, right?
It certainly is. Plant Grow Fly is a pollinator conservation project at the zoo where we encourage people to plant habitat for our hardworking insects like bees and butterflies and hummingbirds. They're responsible for 1 out of every 3 bites of food that we eat as pollinators.
That's an amazing statistic.
It really is, yeah. And most people don't realize how important they are.
Right, and how many years has Plant Grow Fly been operating?
Since 2014, and so you can plant a garden at your home, at your work, at your school, register it with the zoo at plantgrowfly.com. It's a free 5-minute online form. We'll send you a little certificate in the mail, and you can be an official Plant Grow Fly garden. We've got almost 1,300 gardens registered with the project so far, and we're hoping to get to 1,400 by the end of this year.
Oh, I think you will, because yeah. It really has caught on, hasn't it?
It really has. It's super easy to help pollinators, and everyone's very concerned about honeybees and especially the monarch butterfly, which I brought some monarchs here today. And it's easy to help them. And so I feel like monarchs are the bald eagle of this generation. We see that something is happening, we're going to make the right decision and save it.
Yep. And you guys do a great job. There's lots of resources out there and connecting us to them in regards to getting plants, to getting seeds, so making it very accessible and easy for all of us to help contribute to that.
Our website is a clearinghouse of information. Everything that you need to know on how to plant your garden, how to identify the insects that you see, and everything about milkweed, this beautiful little flower that has kind of a PR problem because weed's in its name, and the common milkweed used to grow in the farm rows. But with modern agricultural practices, it's not going to invade the fields anymore. And this is the only host plant of the monarch butterfly. There's several species of milkweed that are native to Iowa, but the caterpillars can't eat anything else but milkweed leaves.
Right. And they really are a hardy plant, so they're easy to grow, and mm-hmm. then once you kind of get them established, they take off.
Exactly, especially common milkweed. Not everybody wants to put common milkweed in their backyard. I do.
I do too.
It's some people liken it to putting a bowl in the china shop if you're used to those more well-behaved garden varieties.
And I'm glad you said that, because I've just noticed that this year, because when Plant Grow Fly first started, we began our journey mm-hmm. to try to reestablish milkweed at our place. And here's what it looks like now.
Wonderful.
Look at that. Isn't that beautiful?
It's absolutely amazing how this thing has grown, and now I'm seeing some offshoots. I tried to transplant one over on the left. You can see some little tiny ones. Those are offshoots from the ones we planted about 6 feet over to the right. So these are underground, and they're popping up now along the way. But this is what we discovered just a couple of weeks ago. At one time, we were mowing or did something, went out there, we had 7 of them.
That's
at
amazing.
One time, 7 of these caterpillars out there. I hadn't seen a caterpillar on a milkweed plant that we owned since I was a kid. If that tells you anything. But amazing that these things just appeared like that, and they weren't small either. Those were pretty big ones.
Exactly. And so if you're up for putting common milkweed because it does behave like that, we'd certainly recommend it. And don't forget, the blooms are nectar for all kinds of adult pollinators. But if you want a variety of milkweed that behaves a little bit more like the plants you're used to in your mm-hmm. garden, we would really recommend butterfly weed, which has those beautiful orange flowers, or swamp milkweed, which looks a little similar to this, but smells like cotton candy.
No, I noticed the last couple of times we were at Zoo Brew, and we're gonna be there again tonight at Zoo Brew night again. People were walking around with milkweed. Explain what that is.
We got a grant through the Association of Zoos and Aquariums called the Zoo Park Partnership Grant to deepen our partnership with Neil Smith National Wildlife Refuge. And this year we have 10,000 native plant plugs to give away, including milkweed, of course, host plants and nectar plants. So we're giving them away at the zoo at least through July, on Saturday mornings from 10 to noon at the Butterfly Garden, and every Zoo Brew every Wednesday night.
Isn't that cool?
And so you can go home with these.
See, again,
with these
making
very
it very easy for people to help.
All right, now speaking of that, let's take a look at what you brought. You brought some friends with you here today.
I certainly did.
Okay.
We have a caterpillar over here first, and he is munching away on a common milkweed leaf. So let's back up a little bit and talk about the life cycle. An adult butterfly will find a milkweed plant and lay usually 1 egg per plant.
One
egg. The egg only lasts for 2 or 3 days, and then a tiny little caterpillar will emerge. And the caterpillars go through 5 instars. They shed their skins 5 times and get bigger and bigger and bigger. So this is probably a 2nd or 3rd instar. And you can see they are voracious eaters.
Non-stop eaters.
Just munch, 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 munch. And so after they get to the 5th instar, which is what this guy was just a couple days ago, because I wanted to bring a very big caterpillar on your show.
Right.
But instead,
he decided
he was ready to turn into a chrysalis.
Keep that still for a second. We'll see if we can get a shot of that. But that is a chrysalis. That will turn into a butterfly. Now, will that chrysalis stay about that size, or will it continue to grow?
It might get a little bit bigger. It's going to stay about that size. It's going to be in a chrysalis for 2 weeks. And right before it ecloses out of the chrysalis, you'll see the patterns of the wings inside.
The outside will become clear.
The outside is always clear.
It's always clear.
We're seeing what's inside.
Really?
Isn't that interesting?
I didn't know that.
So the monarch butterfly will eclose. They'll pump all the blood into their wings. They'll need to dry for about 8 hours, and then they'll fly away.
All right. Now, we're gonna keep these guys here, right? So we can watch the progress every day. We'll check in on them and see
and
how
you
they're
recommend,
doing.
It is a good idea. You can bring some of them indoors, and especially if you have kids, and watch them turn into the chrysalis and emerge, and then the important thing is to then release them.
I'm glad that you mentioned that. There was a study that actually was just released yesterday, and it was covered widely on NPR and other media outlets. And it is discouraging people from taking a lot of eggs out of the wild or buying eggs from a vendor, any of that rearing in large quantities. But it is okay to bring a couple inside your home to rear a couple to show your family and your friends, to really, you know, encourage people to save them.
It's an amazing process, isn't it?
It really is. You'll never forget it.
Right. And again, you want to save some of them too, because we had like 7 or 8 of them. We think the chrysalises are around the house somewhere. We don't know where. Hopefully they're
or they were food.
Or they were food for
which is okay. Which is okay too.
Okay, that's all part of the life cycle.
They're very camouflaged. It's very rare to find a chrysalis in the wild.
Okay.
And you can see those little gold dots actually refract light, so predators are less likely to see them.
All right, so really neat there. Speaking of neat and talking about some things that look visually stunning, we have some visually stunning pieces that are around here too. Explain what these are all about.
We partner with Conservation Fusion. It is an organization that works in Madagascar in very remote areas to save lemurs and tortoises by uplifting the local people. In about 2015, we helped Conservation Fusion build a dream school for 75 kids there who before that had no place to learn about math, reading, but also about nature and wildlife. Now there's 175 kids going to that school, and they need another dream school. To build a dream school in Madagascar, it's less than $50,000, so we are helping Conservation Fusion make the money that she needs. Susie Lewis, who is the founder.
Yeah,
we talked to her last week.
We met her last week. Mm-hmm. She's just in Omaha. And so one of the ways that she is making money for the Dream School and for these amazing kids and wildlife in Madagascar is by selling these handmade goods. And all of these goods are handmade by local people in Madagascar. And this gives them a sustainable livelihood, a way that they can support their family without going and depleting the natural resources. So these are going to be for sale tonight at Zubro.
Yeah, they were for
beautiful.
Sale last week.
And
we showed them.
Reasonably priced.
Very reasonably priced.
So you can kind of get maybe one of each.
Yeah, Michelle had a whole bag about this big full of them last week when she left.
They're beautiful. And, you know, to know that they were made by the people over there, and they're using a lot of different unique materials that they have in their area.
Exactly.
And it's helping out, like you mentioned, a beautiful cause.
It's the holistic view of conservation. Conservation Fusion takes in consideration the health and welfare of individual animals, the health of animal populations, the health of the environment, and most importantly, the health and aspirations of the local people.
Yeah, so tonight we're going to be strutting our stripes, much like the caterpillars, okay? And Abby Normal is going to be on stage tonight, so you know they are an incredible band, so we're going to have a lot of fun with them. We're going to be hanging out there for a while, too. And
some good weather tonight, too.
Yes, it's going to be great.
Nice and warm, and plenty of beverages to keep everybody hydrated. That's the whole idea.
We hope to see everybody there.
Jess, thank you so much for coming in.
Thank you so much.
And thank you for our new friends. We'll take good care of them, and then we will set them free.
All right, it is.